All right, we're gonna ask ChatGPT to write our next tutorial. So I've given the prompt here, write a video script by me, Josh, developer advocate at Zeppelin, on how to use design tokens with the Zeppelin API. So let's see how it does. Okay, opening shot of Josh sitting at his desk. Okay, nice, nice. Hi everyone, I'm Josh, developer app. Okay, let's try it. Hey everyone, I'm Josh, a developer advocate at Zeppelin. Today I'm going to show you just one of the many ways that you can use design tokens from Zeppelin to automate some of your development process. And the example I'll be using today is for Tailwind CSS in a React app built with Vite, but the utility we'll be building to sync your design tokens will be a standalone script that you can extend to fit your exact workflow. And we'll be using design tokens for colors again, like my last video on this topic, and the same script we write today can be applied to textile and spacing tokens, of course. It's just that doing something with color tokens are the most visually obvious for explaining what we'll do today. So we'll take a look at the code, but you can also access the repo from the GitHub link in the description. And there's also some other scripts with the Zeppelin JavaScript SDK that can come in handy for you in that repo to explore. So for our example today, we have this travel app that has our normal brand theme on it. And I'll look at the Zeppelin style guide and see that we've used a contextual naming convention to describe our colors. So in this case, brand primary is like this header color and this button color here. This is a pretty popular practice for naming colors. So instead of naming this color something like yellow or butter or minion, so you'll find that it's a lot more flexible if your app does any rebranding or maybe you want to apply a holiday theme. Having your color semantically named just means that you have to update just those color values instead of doing any risky global find and replace throughout your code when that specific color is named. So for our rebranding, I have another style guide in Zeppelin with those shiny new brand colors. Now you can of course just copy and paste values with the design tokens provided, but since we're in the business of automation, we'll get going with a command line app and the Zeppelin SDK, along with the help of some other libraries like Commander, which will give our app some options in the command line, and also .env, to store our personal access token for the Zeppelin API. If you haven't done any work yet with the Zeppelin API or our JavaScript SDK, check out our video on getting started that I've linked down below in the description, and just pause now and come back here when you're ready. For your main app, you'll want to point your theme file to get its colors from a separate file that will edit automatically when we apply a new color theme. My app is using Tailwind CSS, so that means I'll head to my Tailwind config and import a file that I've called colors.cjs and reference that in the theme. And my colors.cjs file is just a simple module.exports object with the current colors. And I've created another file called getTailwindColors, and you can have this located wherever you keep your developer utilities like this, or in a separate repo just for scripts like I've done here. And we've already imported the Zeppelin SDK, Commander, and .env, and also Node's built-in FS module, which will help us make the edits to the color file that we've created earlier. Now I've set our environment file to .env in our root directory, and in that .env I have our personal access token and the location of our colors file with the environment variable theme colors path. And now that we've got our personal access token imported, we can instantiate the Zeppelin SDK here. Again, if you're not familiar with that process, that's in the video I mentioned earlier or it's linked below. We'll also start our new program with Commander with const program equals new command, and we'll just let that hang out here and use that later. Next, we just want to create a function to get our design tokens. So in today's example, we'll just be using the colors. So we'll call this function getDesignTokenColors and accept the styleguide ID as the argument. Then use the getStyleguideDesignTokens endpoint. This endpoint can be used for getting all of our design tokens, which can include spacing and textile tokens if they're configured in your Zeppelin style guide. So you can work with your designer to make sure that gets done. Oh, that's a very close team. So we'll just destructure the colors object from the response data, though you can certainly apply the same method of calling the endpoint and transforming the response for your workflow with the textile or the spacing tokens from the design tokens endpoint as well. So when we use object.entries and pass in the colors object here, it will return each color in a tuple with the key being the color name and the value of the colors object in the 0 and 1 index. So let's just take a look at the Zeppelin docs. It could probably be better if I have a visual example here, and the color name here, yellow, will appear as that 0 index of that tuple, and everything beyond will be in the first index. So for our use, we just need the value property, which gives us the RGB color, and then we use the color name and value to populate a simplified object. And we'll see that in action in just a second here, but first we have to create our Commander app, which we earlier called the variable program. So we'll start off with program.requiredOption, and it takes three arguments, so we can add dash S for the style guide ID. And the second argument will be the long form version of it, of that option, so I'll just call it dash dash style guide ID. And the third argument string is what will show up as the hint when you run this JavaScript file and just type dash dash help. So we'll just call it style guide ID in plain language here. Now, when it comes to actually doing something with those arguments, we'll chain on the action method and make it an async function here, calling on our getDesignTokensColor function, passing in the style guide ID that will be given to the command when you run the app. So we'll want to take that object and wrap it in module.exports because remember, we've created a module for our theme file, and we saw that earlier. The third argument of the stringify method is to include two spaces for indentation for each line, just for readability purposes. And we'll just console log here to see it in our terminal as it's happening. That'll be helpful for us. Now, lastly, we'll call on the FS module to write the file, giving it the location of our theme file and what we want to be written to that file, which is the parsed colors. And the format of that text encoding can be UTF-8 for
us ordinary humans.
Then we just need to call our program, program.parseAsync and process.argv, and that's the arguments vector. And the syntax there, process.argv, will contain the style guide ID that we put into the command line. So let's just try it in our terminal. So I'll get the ID of our style guide from our new rebranding style guide from the address bar here. And then navigate to the directory of our app and type in node get tailwind colors dash S, then paste in that ID. I've done that right here. So now as easy as that, we've got our nice new object with the new theme automatically entered into the colors file we defined. And your linter, like mine, will probably get pretty mad at you if you've got your configuration set to be single quotes, but that's a pretty quick fix. And now once Vite hot reloads, which it already did, our new colors are mapped out here. And we can see, you know, it's much better than having to do any global find and replace a bunch of times. All right, so I hope that was pretty easy to follow along with. It's a simple but useful integration of our API, but we're here to inspire you to do even more complex things to fit your exact workflow. And we'd love to see what you're working on, so you can join us at our community in the links in the description, and that's where you'll find me and other Zeppeliners to come say hi and chat about what you're working on. So I'll see you next time.